So one of the honeycombs that I didn't get in my practice file or in my previous run of this is right here. That should not have hurt. Stupid game. You're silly. The game and I don't get along sometimes. Like, I don't know. Like, sometimes I'm just running the dishwasher, and then the game says, oh, but I was gonna load that. And then I realize, oh, well they weren't doing so, they were dirty. And so then we get in a fight, and I end up doing all the dishes. And then I do the next set of dishes, and then I have to set the table, and then we just got divorced. The game and I just got divorced. Man, I completely forgot about this room. Oh, look at this. Okay, so there was a storage of acorns after all. It was just in here. Yeah, that's a pretty sufficient amount of acorns, I'd say. What's that up there? Strange. So isn't the honeycomb supposed to be in here? I'm pretty sure it is. Because why would they hide something so well? Oh, there it is. Yeah, you honey nut Cheerio. Hiding out with all the acorns. Yeah, this kind of makes me think of the Great Deku Tree in Ocarina of Time. That's another game I want to LP, even though it's been overdone so many times. It's been done like a bajillion and a half times. I've already been in here. Why am I in here again? Oh, fun fact, not related to the fanfare thing. Any other time that you go into Nabnut's house, like in the springtime or in the summertime or in autumn, but not in the winter because that's the one with the stop and swap egg, it has very specific music for Nabnut. And it's this really fun music, but it goes on for a really long time, and then all of a sudden it brings up like this crazy orchestra. And it's surprisingly it's surprisingly detailed and surprisingly, like, I don't know, loud and crazy for a song that's in such an insignificant small location that you're not in for a very long time. It's just kind of funny. And that music is the bonus music in the Banjo-Kazooie soundtrack, which is why I know about that. Otherwise I would have probably never noticed that, how it booms into this crazy orchestra. So yeah, as you heard from Grunty, this ice water depletes your health twice as fast, just like the oil water. And you lose air even on the surface. And every time I swim through this water, it kind of looks like Kazooie's wings are frosting at the top. Which I'm never able to... I can never tell whether or not that's actually happening or whether it just looks that way. But yeah, that's all the Honey Nut Cheerios. Every single one of them. That is phantasmagoric, even though I don't know what that means, so that's probably not the right word. That's probably not the right word at all. My word choice is like a pantry full of starving basketballs. I'm probably gonna die here, but that would work pretty well. Well, no, I mean, yeah. It wouldn't be bad, is what I was trying to say. Oh yeah. This is so great. This is a great world to end on. It's just so... It's not like most games. It's just really not like most games. Most games just kind of throw you into a really dark world that puts a whole lot of stress on you. And this world is just so laid back. Except for the notes. Which I'm gonna get in the speed-up thing, so see you in that. Thank you. And that is all 100 notes in Click Clockwood and all 900 notes in the game. There are no more than that. So, next time on Banjo-Kazooie, we're going to witness one of the greatest ideas in video game history. A lot of questions will be raised, and a lot of them will be answered, if you know what I mean. See you then, and thank you for watching.